Academy that really impresses me is the range and the quality of experiences staff provide to enrich the lives of every student. Last year saw the first Bangor Academy ski trip since 2001. 30 students, accompanied by Mr. Falls, Ms. Haydock and Ms. Watson, travelled to the Italian resort Pila. The group experienced fantastic snow conditions and enjoyed the evening activities. And in February next year, 40 students are going to San Martino, Italy. And our students continue to excel in the full range of extracurricular activities. At the Hollywood Festival, the Consort Choir achieved third place. They bettered that later in the year by achieving first place at the Bangor Festival. 9 girls auditioned and became members of the Ulster Youth Choir. Megan Hannah, Charlotte Skip, Caitlin Nichol, Lucy Bagwell, Hannah O'Neill, Emily Topping, Lydia Weir, Fiona Humphries and Ashton Meyer. And it's easy to measure sporting success in terms of final awards and prizes. But for me, a significant part of the success of sport at Bangor Academy is the sheer number and range of opportunities on offer. But we do obviously have a range of individual and team successes to recognise this afternoon. Jack Henderson became successful in Northern Ireland football. Jack Hamilton and Andrew Smith, Regional Development Academy for rugby. Dylan Eagleson and Owen McCleary both became Ulster boxing champions. Maya Marcy came second in the National Diving Championships. The Year 8 football team, you saw them on a video earlier, reached the semi-final of the Northern Ireland Cup and won the North Down League. The Year 9 football team were the North Down League winners. The Year 11 football team were the North Down League winners. Morgan Nelson, Jude Devlin, Connor Ogle and Michael Evans were golf Ulster junior champions. The Year 8 girls were the cross-country North Down champions, Katie Stevenson, Anna Bishop and Tisha Connolly and Emma Hamilton. The Year 9 girls were the cross-country North Down championships, Courtney Keogh, Ellie Nichols, Holly McBride. Taylor Dunlop, the Northern Ireland trampolining under 14 elite champion. Jenny Graham, Lucy McElmayo, Jessica Black were selected for the under 13 Regional Development Academy for netball. Kerry Roberts, Nicole Lowry, Rebecca Skillen were selected for the same thing in the older age group. And then the under 16 netball team were the Tagsa champions. And Hannah Harris, selected for the Ulster under 18 rugby squad. Luke Buchanan was the Ulster Youth Games under 17 champion for badminton. And our equestrian team placed third overall in the Ulster Schools Championship. The league ran for 6 months, and within that time, many of our riders enjoyed individual firsts, seconds, and thirds. We were only narrowly picked at the post on the very last day. Before we move on to the Key Stage 4 awards, I want to give you an update, a brief summary of news from different departments. Last year, in business studies, the Year 12 students took the opportunity to run their own businesses over lunchtimes and had a visiting entrepreneur speaking with the class on how we did it. In Year 13, linked with Denwood Plastics, the students spent weeks running their own business. There were geography field trips to Colin Glen to study rivers in Year 9, Tato Chris Factory to study economic activity in Year 10, and to the River Shimna in Newcastle in Year 11. In the History Department, Year 9 visited the Tower Museum, Londonderry, to explore the plantations and the treasures from the Spanish Armada. Year 10 visited the Somme Centre, Conlake, to experience life in the trenches of the Great War, and Year 10 participated with the Council for Holocaust Memorial Day by contributing work to the display in Bangor Library. Learning for Life and Work continued to offer a range of opportunities for all students. Travel and tourism classes visited the Titanic Visitor Centre, Giant's Causeway, Belfast Zoo, Belfast Sightseeing Open Top Bus Tour, the Crumlin Road Jail. And they also participated in a Young Enterprise Masterclass. In technology and design, Year 10 students completed a CNC course on the STEM bus. Students designed and manufactured name plaques as an introduction to CAD and CAM. Year 13 and 14 A-level students visited Bright Bus Limited in Ballymena to observe the stages of manufacture from the design table to the completed bus. And Year 13 and 14 attended a lecture by the Northern Irish architect Patrick Bradley, famous for his shipping container house, featured on Grand Designs and nominated for House of the Year. A-level art students visited the Seacourt Print Workshop in October, and some fabulous etchings were produced. Year 9 had an amazing visit from the Owl Man, who had us all captivated with owls flying around this assembly hall and snakes for students to hold. Year 10 students made a felted Christmas tree for the Festival of Trees in the First Bangor Church. And GCSE and A-level students visited the True Colours exhibition at the Ulster Museum to see a selection of work from students from all over Northern Ireland. And we held our own annual exhibition in June to celebrate the work of all of our exam classes, with 6 of the pieces chosen by an arts representative from Ards Arts to be exhibited for the public throughout the summer. And one of our students, Leanne McAleese in Year 13, was one of only 5 students in Northern Ireland to be awarded the Thomas Devlin Bursary Award for work in the visual arts. The drama department staged over 30 different performances last year, along with theatre trips to see Sleeping Beauty, A Midsummer Night's Dream, a screening of the National Theatre's Macbeth, Blood Brothers and Heroine. And at the Bangor Speech and Drama Festival, Ashton Myatt and Jessica Power were awarded first place in the Over 16 Duologue class for their presentation of Steel Magnolias, and other competitors from Bangor Academy were awarded highly commended. Following a short video, you'll then see the Key Stage 4 prizes.
Hi, I'm David. I got my GCSEs results today. I got an A star in engineering, 4 A's in geography, physics, learning for life and work, and PE. I also got 4 B's, and next year I tend to go to sixth form college again. Now she's stronger than you know. A heart of steel starts to grow. On his life he's been told he'll be nothing when he's old. All the kicks and all the blows he won't ever let it show. 'Cause he's stronger than you know. A heart of steel starts to grow. When you've been fighting for it all your life, you've been struggling to make things right. That's how a superhero.
Hello, my name's Jamie. I just got my GCSE results. I got an A star in religious studies and 2 A's in geography and moving image arts. I also got 4 B's and 2 C's. Next year I'm hoping to come back to sixth form.
My name's Emma and I just got my GCSE results and I'm really happy. I got 4 A's in RE, Geography, History and Child Development, and I got 5 B's in Maths, English Language and English Literature, French and Biology, and I'm hoping to go into sixth form next year and do RE, Geography, English Literature and Child Development.
Hi, my name is Arar. Today I've got my GCSE results. Got 2 A's, 1 in Math and 1 in LFL, Learning for Life and Work. Got 4 B's in Maths, Chemistry, Business Studies and ICT. Got 2 C's, 1 in English, another 1 in Technology and Design. And next year I'm hoping to get into Wallace High School to do my A-levels, which are Biology, Chemistry, Maths and Engineering.
Key Stage 4 Awards. The Child Development Award and the BTEC Level 2 Extended Certificate for Physical Education, Sarah Borland. The BTEC Level 2 Extended Certificate for Science and Occupational Studies, Natalie Gilbert. David Cassells. David Cassells and Andrew Thompson. In addition, Andrew has also won the award for technology and design. French, Thomas Rogan. Geography and history, Emma Mitchell Brannigan. Health and social care, Emma Stevenson. Achievement Award for Examination Success, Claire Adams. Ross Barber. Jamie Brush. David Cassells. GCSE results, 2 A stars, 4 A's, 3 B's, Claire Adams.